Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.
A very good evening to everybody, and I welcome you to the launch of Season 6 of NSE FinWiz. And on behalf of CNBC TV 18 and NSE, I welcome you all to this historic venue, the world's second largest trading exchange by equity volumes, National Stock Exchange. Well, NSE has not just employed technology and increased transparent trading, but is also very well known for pioneering initiatives that spread valuable investor education. FinWiz is one such initiative that is taken by NSE and has been on ground for last 5 years that has visited top companies across India. We are here today for the launch of Season 6, and this year, FinWiz is set to achieve greater heights and reach out to many more people and young professionals like you here. And to kick off the evening, may I please request Manisha Gupta, the editor of Commodities and Currencies, CNBC TV 18, to deliver the opening address.
We welcome you all aboard for the proud launch, as Sonal mentioned, for the Season 6 of NSE FinWiz, powered by CNBC TV 18. Well, it has been 25 years since NSE has been around creating prosperity. And on that note, you can actually tune in on every 25th on CNBC TV 18 as we talk, educate, enable, and empower you on investing decisions in the Indian economic markets here. Well, when we talk about prosperity and we talk about financial discipline, it really is about the right investing decision on timely, also with the right products really, and in the current market condition. So the whole idea is to ensure a direct involvement, getting credible faces, also getting regulatory representatives, and of course industry experts, as we have today, to tell you on how to really trade. So there are a few things really that I want to say before we begin this. It is not always easy to get it right. We have seen, as we approach to the 2018 end, we've seen what kind of a year it really has been. So what we need to do really is about set clear goals, ensure that we are looking at performances, analyze, set them correct. And, it is usually said that profitability is mostly right, around the corner. It always actually is about getting it right, ensuring that there is financial discipline. And that is something that once you get is difficult to shrug off. So that is something, the core of it all. And that is what we are looking to really imbibe and achieve via our Season 6. Thank you, Sonal.
In Season 6, NSE FinWiz motivates you to invest in yourself. That is the path to prosperity. And we will try and help guide you to identify the financial products that you can invest in and also to grow your wealth. And tell us more on where and how much to invest. I would like to call Mr. Vikram Limai, MD and CEO of National Stock Exchange, on board.
NSE FinWiz is a program conceived to help youngsters start investing early in their careers. Its aim is to make you understand the power of investing wisely. It hopes to equip you with simple advice and several real-life examples by experts to make what you earn more for itself. NSE FinWiz focuses on how to grow your savings, how to create wealth, and most importantly, how to protect your wealth from eroding. It will help you understand various investment options and the benefits and risks attached to each one. NSE FinWiz aims to empower you to seek the right options and take the right decisions when it comes to your financial well-being. This year is a very special year for NSE as we celebrate our Silver Jubilee. At NSE, we believe that we're not 25 years old, but like any other youngster like yourselves, our future lies ahead of us. The world recognizes India's potential, and it is up to all of us to help India achieve that potential. My best wishes to all of you for a highly successful NSE FinWiz 2018 and for your careers ahead. As we say at NSE, may prosperity always bloom. Thank you very much.
Thank you, everybody, for being here. And thank you, Mr. Lemay, for taking time out to have this conversation. All of us, of course, we want to earn more, we want to save more, we want to spend less, and we want to invest very, very wisely. So to all the first-timers or the beginners who are entering into the markets, what would your advice really be?
Unless you understand what you're investing in, I don't think you'd be able to make an informed choice. So I would encourage everyone to take the effort to learn. It's hard-earned money. So you should obviously be careful about what you do with it. And the only way you can, you know, make an informed choice is if you take the time and effort to learn about markets, to learn about different investment options, to learn about yourself in terms of what you're comfortable with, in terms of your own risk appetite, and then, you know, make the right choices.
So, the kind of generation that we are right now, we all want it very quick. So is it always about making that quick buck? Or, I mean, as you say, it should be slow, steady, start investing with less, take your time.
I do believe that you should start investing at a young age because your ability to take risk is obviously a lot higher when you're younger because your working life is, you know, decades more. So in order to start investing early, you've got to start learning about markets. And then once you're comfortable that you understand what you're doing, you should start taking risk. And you should start taking risk more from a long-term perspective rather than from a trading standpoint.
Well, absolutely. So what is your advice? Invest in an SIP or go buy a home?
I would say that if you had to sequence it, then I would start investing first. And then once you've got some equity, some ability to finance the purchase of your home, then think about buying a home.
So when you are advising the youngsters to go ahead and invest first, what kind of products should one then look at for the beginner?
I think the SIP trend is a healthy trend because you're not trying to time the market. I hope people understand what an SIP is so that when there is volatility in the market, people don't stop investing and disappear from the market. That's not the idea of an SIP. I would say that SIP is the right way to go. Invest through cycles, invest for the long term, invest a small sum of money, whatever it is that you believe in terms of your own portfolio allocation is risk appetite that allows you to sleep well at night as well as grow your wealth over time. And that's the right way to do it.
The kind of education that we have right now, the financial institutions that are around, do not really cater to students as much. I mean, FinWiz, of course, has been one of those things that we do here. But what is your sense on the kind of academics that we have right now and how much of that really needs to change to ensure, to imbibe that kind of a culture in the market?
I think we have to start early and we have to have financial education as a core part of our curriculum, even at schools. Mm. So, you know, we've made some effort in that direction. And actually, we have a financial education course, which is now part of the CBSE system. So CBSE schools offer an NSE design course as an optional course for financial education. I think that should be encouraged. Mm. It's important to develop knowledge of savings, investments, basics of finance at an early stage. It's an important life skill to have. And I think we need to do more in terms of encouraging schools and colleges to have financial education as a core part of the curriculum.
A last questions before I let you go. And this one really is about the new initiatives that have come in this year itself. Commodities for one, what is the roadmap on that one? And of course, the other one is about the corporate bonds. How are you looking at both of these markets and what are the plans ahead?
So commodities, we started only about a month, 6 weeks ago. So it's early days. You have more of the financial investor types who are playing in the commodities market. You have to balance that with the institutional and the hedging community. And so you have to take a long-term view in terms of how you try to develop that market. Right. It requires investing. It requires having the right kind of products. And therefore, we are also coming up with some differentiated products that would help get the hedging community involved.
Also, how is the 10 a.m. to 12 in the night market treating you? That's commodities.
It's okay. I mean, it's new for us, but there are others who've been doing it. So our guys will also get used to it. So that's fine. I don't think the working hours or the market hours is a problem. On the fixed income side as well, we have a long way to go. It's very early days. And I think if you look at even what the regulatory tone has been, whether RBI or SEBI, they want some of the larger corporates to
to source their financing needs more from the bond market.
That's right.
At least a portion of their financing needs from the bond market. And for that, you need a robust enough bond market to be able to finance corporates and not just the AA plus and higher. And we're doing a few things to try and get that expedited, including we launched a corporate bond repo in order to get retail participation in G6. We've launched this platform that allows retail investors to buy government bonds. But it's across the spectrum. I mean, there are lots of things that are in the works. And the good news is that I find both SEBI and RBI coordinated in seeing the bond market develop.
On that note, Mr. Limayya, thank you so much for taking time out.
Thank you very
much. Thank you so much for that conversation.
Thanks a lot.
A very warm welcome to all our panelists, and thank you so much for taking time out and being with us here today. It is about creating a financial discipline to ensure that there are products, that there is awareness, to ensure that we create, that we save, that we can protect the kind of investments that we are making. So before we get any further, let me come to each one of you and get your first word out on what the market scenario is right now, what needs to be done, what are the kind of investments that we are seeing, and also what kind of awareness does this market really need at this point in time. Vishakha, let's begin with you.
When you're talking about investing for your future, when you're talking about investing from a financial discipline perspective, when you're talking about creating for the long term, what the market is doing today is really not that important, because that is the nature of the beast. You know, it's not going to stay constant. It is not going to stay at any one trend. It is going to be volatile. So I think it's just like that. We just need to take it as it comes.
All right. Firoz, let me come to you then. What is your sense on the short term and the long term?
See, I think when it comes to long term and short term debate, point one is you have to understand who you are. Mm. Are you a trader? Are you an investor? That's the first question you have to ask yourself. Mm. If you are a trader, you have to get the direction of the market. If you are an investor, you have to get the trend of the market. When investors try and get the direction, then there's something which is counterintuitive. So that's point one. The second point which I want to leave the group with is to say, before you manage anything, you will have to measure it. Right? Risk in our industry or any industry of finance, largely, from an investor standpoint, has been an English word. Conservative, moderate, aggressive. But risks have measurements. So you should try and, like Mr. Limayya was saying, you will have to spend time to learn, to understand the two sides of the coin. One is well understood, the other isn't. That's point two. Point three is, people always try to outsmart the neighbor. Outsmarting is a far difficult thing to do, but out-disciplining somebody is a far easier thing to do. So if you keep these three in mind, I think you will be able to arrive at the long term with far more prosperity.
Well, Radhika, let me come to you. Most of us think that mutual funds are magical. You put money in them and by the year end, you will come back with the double-digit returns there. What has been the experience? What has been the feedback? And how magical is it?
Everybody's goals in this room and on air are different. Some people may be naturally conservative. Some people may be moderate. Some people may be aggressive. So you have to go in with very, very clear expectations from your investing. What goals are you investing from? And then match your investments to meet those goals. I think what tends to happen, coming to your question, you know, regarding our mutual funds magic, is that in good markets, and we've seen those in 2017, and I'll address many mutual fund investors who've come into this industry then, we see very, very large headline numbers on mutual fund returns, 15%, 20%, 30%. It is important to remember that markets move in cycles. So for every 2017, you will have a 2008, you will have a 2011. Neither is the reality. The reality is something called the average. And the average, by definition, is a very, very muted number. But the truth is that Indian markets have compounded at some 10-11% effectively now with LTCG. That's about 10-11% tax-free if you've just held on for 5 to 7 years. That's not magic, but I can tell you it's a very good outcome for most investors.
Point taken that. Sharad, coming to you as well, what has been your sense?
Thanks, Manish. I'll talk more about the from a real estate perspective and blend the equity and the asset allocation within that. If you look at long periods of time, there are only two asset classes which has created wealth, not only in India, globally. One is equity, other is real estate. timing and the size of allocation towards the asset class can be debated. But to say that one should remain absent from real estate because of the challenges which the sector has faced in the last couple of years, would not be advisable. On long period of time, the real estate has generated a return which will be between 12 to 14%, a rental yield of 2%, and a capital gain of between 10 to 12%. That's a reasonable expectation to have. There are other ways to invest into real estate as well. There are financial assets, and it will be interesting for audience here and at the home to understand that there are ways to participate into real estate which is just beyond the physical real estate. One is alternate funds, which gives an opportunity to participate through a formal fund route to participate into real estate. And there is something very interesting, hopefully by the year end we will have, which is called REITs. We can have a whole thing on the REIT, but I think real estate is getting organized, getting cleaned up, and it's a good news for all investors.
Mr. Hiranandani, then to you, what is your sense? This is a question I asked Mr. Limai as well. So if I was a beginner, should I be investing in an SIP or should I go buy a house?
I think the right time of buying a house, if I was young, I would do it today if I had the capacity and ability to do. If I don't, I would go to the stock market, take proper advice from my friend sitting on the table over here, build up my capital faster than 12% compounded per annum, and then probably run to buy a house as quickly as possible to do it, and in the meantime, probably do it. But what he said correctly is that the consolidation in the industry is happening very, very fast. And that consolidation is going to really change the face of industry in the next couple of years, and it's happening very, very quickly. So that is going to really give a further security to the whole thing. And instruments like REITs and other instruments which are coming down into the market is really there. But one thing is very, very clear. Those people who are used to looking at stock values every day should not enter the real estate industry because they don't change so fast.
Radhika, final comments with you. What is your sense on what should be an investment strategy right now for a beginner?
I'd say three things. One is start. No matter how much capital you have, take your monthly salary and take some money aside and park it, because start with a habit of saving. I can't emphasize that enough. Just get started. Second is, and in my opinion, the easiest way to get started is to take your monthly salary and start doing a simple SIP to build up a capital base. Secondly, through your journey, understand what your goals are and choose financial products, all products on this platform, to meet those goals. And the third thing, if you're a new investor, whether you're investing in mutual funds or real estate, as he said, don't look at it every day. Genuinely hold on for the long term. You're starting. You have a long, long life ahead.
Very well said. Vishakha, of course, you've mentioned a lot of products there, but what is a smart product for a beginner to get in?
No, actually, I wouldn't want to talk about it from a smart product for a beginner. I think I will build on what was just said. When you look at it from an investor perspective, as an individual, when you start off, there are some very primary goals, okay? And we use a formula called protection, education, retirement, then managing money and legacy planning. So when you put aside money, think of it in very simple terms. First of all, protect it, which is what we talk about from insurance, base term insurance. So your future earning capacity is protected even if you're not there. Then normally what we tend to talk about is, as an individual, educating your children becomes your next priority. And of course, talking about young married professional with kids, if you don't have that, you can skip the education part. Then you'll have short-term needs of, okay, I want to go on a holiday. Decide what it is for. Put aside emergency funds. Then there will be emergency funds. I don't think you should have emergency funds in volatile instruments. You know, liquid is great. Fixed deposits are great. You're not talking about beating inflation for emergency funds. You're talking about having accessibility for emergency funds. So look at it from emergency funds, education funds, retirement funds, and then it is about making money work for you, which is just pure investment for the fun of investment, and making it grow so that you can have the luxuries, you can have the top-ups, and then legacy planning, which you want to leave behind for people.
Absolutely. So Feroz, one, of course, built up on all of this, and all of us do want financial freedom, and for that is needed financial discipline. And for that, you need to understand on how to make a portfolio. So help us in making that.
Creating a portfolio, you should have, in my opinion, 60% in equity if you're a youngster. equity will not disappoint you as long as you can tie your hands down, handcuff yourself, and just go through the roller coaster ride. The roller coaster will end, and you will be safe. To say, what do I do with my 40%? I would say debt. And gold is certainly not even an asset class, it's a currency. So I don't see gold 40% in debt, 60% in equity, as long as there is long-term consumption real estate, by yesterday. That's the summary.
As far as it's making money for us, I'm totally okay with your portfolio there. Mr. Hiranandani, yes.
Yeah, today, if you really study the kind of EMIs that you're paying, and if you look at the inflation which has taken place last couple of years, you're actually paying maybe 2 or 3% interest on the loan that you have borrowed. If you look at the inflation for the last 10, 15 years, so actually the banks are subsidizing you in terms of actually buying a house in terms of it. So that becomes an additional benefit in terms of the increase in the value of the house that you really have seen over a period of years. And the fact that you can invest your long-term capital gains also into the house really makes it extremely easy for you to consider buying the house. As far as the second house is concerned, I agree with all of them. That's an option really we do. So it's really, again, choosing the right fund, choosing the right house, right developer, the right location also. So when you said that you buy good locations which have a future and prospects to do, like you invest into shares and securities and mutual funds, you have the same benefit of looking at the right house.
Thank you so much. And with that, that's all the time that we have here. And thank you so much. A very strong panel, clearly. And they've given you all the right kind of advice here. So what we take away really is invest right, hold it patiently, and continue to prosper. Thank you so much.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.